I mentioned a few days ago that I have added some new nodes in Polygon.js to do CAD modeling. CAD stands for computer-aided design, and that's a kind of technique that is used in industrial design to create objects that you need to manufacture or to print, and is generally used to have more control over complex shapes. And so that's the first batch of nodes. More are going to come. But this video will show you, will give you a quick introduction onto how to use them. So that's the first example scene that you can have a look and to see what kind of object can be generated and how to make them. So if I press Ctrl B to see it in full screen, you can see that it has some nice bevel of varying radius. Some are round, some are flat. It has a series of Boolean shapes. And if we look at the network, it all starts by a box. We add a fillet on one side, then another series of fillet on another side, fillets in the bottom, fillets on the top, and the new fillet all embrace the pre-existing fillets. And we have a series of booleans here, boolean on the top, and then we apply a material. So let's have a look into each of those nodes and see how you can reproduce that. So I'm going to close this tab, and this is now the local app. So I'm going to start a new scene, and this is the default scene. I will delete the sphere, and I will start by, if I type CAD, or if I also look at the tab menu and I see all the nodes that exist, all the CAD nodes that exist, they're all prefixed by CAD, and you can see all of them if you want. But we are going to start by a CAD box. And the first thing that happens when you drop one of those nodes for the first time is you have this error, fail to load Open Cascade Library. So if you have used the GLTF node, which load the GLTF file, it has a similar error. And the first time you use it, the way to go about it is to go to Windows Libraries, and in this case, we're going to install the Open Cascade Library, which is the library that powers the CAD nodes. So I press Install. Now, once it's installed, I will save the scene. So let's call that CAD box. And when it reloads, I should see the box. So it doesn't always work on the first reload. Sometimes you need to reload it a second time. That's something that will be improved in the future. But this is our box. And I will lower the ground a little bit. Let's go with 1.5 so that we clearly see where our object is. And so now the first thing we want to apply to it is a fillet. So I create the CAD fillet node. And by default, the fillet is applied on every edges of our object. And we don't want that. We want to apply the edges, the fillet only on those two edges. So what we have is we have this group parameter here where we can give numbers. That's one way to apply it, to select a specific edge. So here we are going to select that edge. I can go select 0 and 1, or I can even give a range 0 to 3. And that will select not with an equal, with a dash. And that will select the edges 0, 1, 2, and 3. Selecting with IDs or indices is fine, but it's not the most procedural way. If you were to rotate the object, those indices would be at the bottom, for instance, instead of being on the side. So I want a way that is a bit more procedural. One way to go about it is to use the CAD group node. What the CAD group node is basically applies a name to a group of indices or group of edges. For instance, this is going to be our name, and instead of using those indices here, I will simply give the name here. So right now we don't see anything, because if I middle click on that node, I can see that there is no edge on that edge group. So I can need to toggle one of those options to activate some nodes. So I can use by expression for a start, and this will select the first edge. So I can also do the same thing as I've done before with the 0-3. I can say ptnum less or equal to 3, and that will give me those same edges. By expression is one way to do it. One way I like to use as well is by bounding object. So I'm going to toggle that on, and it gives me an error because there is no second input, and I need one in that case. I will place my object here. So I will use a box line, plug it like this, and now I will want, box line is simply this box, and I will move it to the side like this. And now when I press my display flag on that node, I have a preview of which edge are part of the selection. And I only want the two vertical ones. I don't want the top one, the horizontal one. So I will simply lower the size of that. And if you want, it can be useful as well to have those two nodes displayed together, so you see where each are. And so right now I can see that the edges are right on the border of that box. Sometimes it's useful to just make it wider to be sure that they are selected. And so if I display, I put a display flag on that node, I can see that now I do have those two edges. And so if I apply the fillet is indeed applied only on those two edges. So now I will do the same thing for the those two edges here. And one thing I quickly realize is that the group node CAD group is not the most meaningful. So I will simply call it front edges. And I will make sure that I still have that like this. And then I will duplicate those nodes, and I can probably get rid of the merge node and actually realign those so we clearly see which one is with which, like this. And I will want to move that box to the other side. So now I have those two edges. I will call those back edges, if I can spell back edges like this. And now I have those two fillets. And now that's where it starts to be interesting, is I can definitely control the size of one group of fillet independently than the other one. So I will have one much larger like this. And I will also resize my box. This is not the size of the box I wanted, so I want to have it longer. I think 3 and 2 are a good size, like this, maybe even 4. So I can always change that later by repositioning the boxes. So I put that box here, make that one wider, so I know I have those two edges again. And if I go to this one, I move the manipulator like this, make this one wider, and I have those two edges selected here. So now I have my fillet here and my fillet there. Let's make this one a little wider like this. So now let's do the fillet at the bottom. Same technique again. I will take this here, and in that case I will call them bottom edges. Put this like this, and I will move this lower, and I will make that quite big like this. Now I check that I do have my edges. It still takes edges that are vertical. I don't want this in that case, so I keep lowering this like this. And I do want the edges here, so I will move it like that. I make sure I have everything. And now I do not want an round fillet. I want the straight one, so I will make sure it is as small as big as I can, but there is a limit to the resolve that this node has, and so I need to tweak the size so that I get something that still gives me a geometry that is valid. So that seems okay. And now let's duplicate that to have the top fillets. I put that here, I rename that to top edges, and I move that box to the top. And now I do want something a little bigger like this. Good. So that is the main shape of our box, and I can probably still increase the size of those fillets here like this. So now let's add those Boolean shapes on the side. So I will start with a tube, a very simple tube that I don't want on the vertical axis. And I will a CAD tube. So it's important to keep the manipulating node with a CAD prefix together. If I was to try to make a Boolean between this CAD object with a tube, and by the way, you can see when you middle click on those node, the type of object, that is a CAD compound, and here this does not have any CAD prefix. It's just a standard mesh. The Boolean operation would not work, so I really need to use this CAD tube. And you can also, of course, see the color that is different. Then, so I will change the size. I will keep the height a little like this. Actually, I will make sure that the height is centered on the origin. So one thing I like to do is to copy the param and to put that on the center, divided by two, so that whenever I increase the height, so I do want to have minus divided by two. So when I increase the height, it increases equally between the bottom and the top. So I will have it above this, maybe with small radius. And I will use the copy node to duplicate it. So I just said that we should keep the node of the same color together, but there are exceptions, like the copy node can take CAD input or normal input and duplicate them. Same thing with the transfer node, same thing with the box line, we can use it as a second input of the group. There are exceptions to this rule. So I will duplicate like this, five copies for now. Let's have them a little more tight like this. And let's have that on the side of this. So I will have a transform. And here I want to move those exactly to the side of where we are. So I will use a merge node for now to have them both displayed together. And so I could display them manually like this. That's totally possible. I'll probably make it a little shorter right now. But one thing that is useful as well is if I was to change the width of my box, it can be useful to have an expression so that this node would reposition the tubes based on the width of the box. So here I've created a null, which I'm going to use as a reference. And all I want to take from this null is the size of the bounding box, which is the information that is here. And I can use the expression bbox. So I'm going to call bbox, and the argument is going to be the ref node, and I want the max, and I want the z component of that, and that will give me this value. So now if I display both of them together, actually they are on the other side, if I was, for instance, to increase the size of my box, then the tubes would move accordingly. So that's how you make sure that you can have multiple objects that move together based on different constraints, which is a very important criteria to move objects in CAD. So I have those objects, and now I will simply use a CAD boolean like this, and it takes a little bit of time to operate. It did not do its job because let's have a look again. So we have that, and it could be that the tubes are either too tall and are eating on the fillet, or it could be a number of reasons. CAD boolean, so I make sure I have the CAD solid. If I was maybe to make a merge, that could be helpful. And what I have is intersect, so I don't need that. What I want is subtract. And here we are. We have our shape that is being subtracted. So I will go back to those width, make that a little taller. I can reduce the space between them, like this, and I can use a transform now to move them around. And as you can see, the transform now has an expression here, so I cannot move it in the z-axis anymore, but I can still move it like this. I would probably want to have a smaller radius still. Maybe something like this. And I only have it on one side. I wanted to have it on both sides. So I'm going to create a CAD mirror. So if I display it like this, and I should have it on the ZX axis. So now I will use a merge to have both sets of tubes, and I can use the boolean on that. So now I have my gaps holes in here and in here as well. And now let's finish by using the holes, by creating the holes at the top. So I will again use a tube, but I want them in a hexagonal pattern. So in order to place them in this hexagonal pattern, I will use the points that are created from this hexagonal node. So if I simply click on that, I can see that the nodes have this nice hexagonal pattern. And so I will want to place this on the top of that. So I'm going to use a transform node. And I will actually again use this merge node to have those two together. If I move this up, and I don't want that many points, so I will have that higher like this. Maybe this number of points will be good. But it is not centered, so I want to have another transform node like this. This one will not move it up, but I will use a preset center to origin, and now my object is centered. And I would like to make that a little bigger and then increase the step radius again. That should be about correct. I move this here, and now I will again instantiate cubes or tubes, not cubes, tubes on those points. That is how it is. That seems correct. Now I can use my boolean. And it is by default on intersect again. And here we are on subtract. I can make the tubes larger and maybe taller as well. So that's the main gist of it. You can see that the edges here are a little not round enough, and the reason that the default are chosen at the moment so that they are still fast enough, so that whenever you make a modification on this object, those edges have to be recomputed. So you can have them finer by using the CAD triangulate node. So in that case, I will lower those two values, and you can see that now they are very curved. So I will make this to black as well to better see them. But this is our object. So that should give you an idea how to use a CAD node. As you've seen, there is many others you can have fun with, and there will be more to come. I plan to make more tutorial on this subject. That's a very rich subject. And so yes, see you later.